Students, in our chapter staffing, now let us today do the first step in the process of staffing, that is recruitment. So today we are going to learn the meaning of recruitment, what exactly we do in the recruitment, and to recruit the staff, to make an arrangement for the recruitment, which are the sources of recruitment. So the entire question of recruitment, you may have in the one form that has a meaning, what do you mean by recruitment, 1 mark question, or you may have a 5 mark question along, meaning along with the sources of recruitment. Let us begin with now recruitment. The recruitment is the process of looking for a probable employee and making them apply for job. Here we are encouraging the probable members. There are lot many people, those who are looking for a job. So here you have to instinct them that you come forward and you join your job. So we are making an arrangement by which we are encouraging people to come forward for the job, for the application. The rest of the process will be continued later on. But just making an arrangement that two people meet with one another. One and probable employer and one a probable employee. The second form you can say, recruitment is the process of acquiring at the right time, in the right number of people that you want, in the right place, the persons with right qualification. What is your aim? That you want a correct person for your job. There are ample of members looking for a job, but we can't allow anybody to enter in. Their qualification, their experience, their potentials, their qualities, their capabilities to perform the job, all these things are to be taken care of, and only the proper group of people only are encouraged, and we are allowing them to go for the second process of our staffing. So right person you should get, right time you should get, right number of members with a qualification. The another way of expression you can say that recruitment of the staff should be done on the basis of suitable qualification, skill, knowledge and that sincerity, and it not to be based on any influence or a corruption or a nepotism. So you need a labor. It doesn't mean that you are under the influence of someone, and because somebody has reference or recommended, you are taking that person for job. You have to go with the proper process. You have to see the suitable qualification which you are looking for, the skills whether the person is having or not, the knowledge the person is having or not. So here, the influence to be rejected, the corruption, there should not be any money matter involved for the recruitment. You are giving job means let us generate a money for giving that job should not be there. When you go with any of these three methods, then definitely your quality of that person whom you are recruiting, whom you are going to select, is to be, you have to compromise with that quality aspect. So these three elements should not be there in your process of recruitment, so that you have to be careful. The another way of expression for the recruitment, that recruitment is a continuous process to be made when a new enterprise is established. At what time you have to undergo with the process of recruitment? The very first, when you are going to establish a new enterprise, the new business you start. After starting a new business, you are going to expand. Later on, the expansion, at that time you need a person. When somebody retired, or somebody resigned, or somebody died. So these are the events when the question of recruitment arises. So number one, when the establishment of our business organization. Number two, for expansion and modernization and development, we need a latest technological know-how, people. And number three, due to the time constraint, due to the human limitation, when the person retired or he may resign for personal reason or the person may die. So in short, you need the process of recruitment from the day one till continue the business is continuing and activities are going on. So recruitment is a continuous process in which we are encouraging members to go for the selection procedure, and we try to arrange the meeting between two persons, that is what the probable employer and probable employee. So now to do this particular work, which are the available sources? Which sources can help you to get the labor? So here you can say the sources can be classified into two ways, internal source and the external source. Within an organization itself, you will get your few of the requirements. If very few members you are in need, then your organization itself is a source to get the member. In that internal source, internal means when you get your labor from within the business organization itself. The first is that promotion. If there is a higher order need of an employee, the so many employees are working at a secondary level and at a bottom level. If the need is there, the most efficient member, the most capable member, and the employee who is able to give justice to the activity, you can give promotion to that member. So by giving a promotion, upgrading, you are also motivating a person, you are also satisfying your need, as well as your work can be done easily without looking outside and without going with any unknown person. Your own member can be uplifted from lower cadre to the higher cadre. So give more authority, give more power, give more responsibility, give more salary, and from your within source only satisfy the need of your job. Number two, transfer. There are lot many employees, they have their personal issues and their personal requirement. Then to satisfy those requirement as well as to satisfy the business requirement, so many times we are transferring a labor, our own employee, from one department to another department, from one branch to another branch, from one city to another city. We have our activities already spread into the various places. So just by accommodating member from one to another place, also your need of recruitment gets over. So this transfer can be done for two reasons. On the request of an employee or because of the need of organization. So compulsory transfer can also be given and request transfer can also be given. So that is what the need to be satisfied, the labor to be accommodated. Number three, friends and relatives of employees. Your own employees are there. You can ask them by giving a notice or circular that in our organization we are looking for few members, new employees. If any capable people are available in your relatives or in your friend circle or nearby, then you can ask them to approach. So with this two benefit you can get. Number one, that you are showing that you trust your employees. You are showing that you give an opportunity to employees that their family member can also get the job. So in this way, one kind of motivation, one kind of positivity and one kind of appreciation, you allow your friends and relatives to recommend employees. The next possibility, that recalling the retrenched employees. So many times we have compulsorily given the VRS. VRS can be of two types, that is voluntary retirement and compulsory retirement. Sometimes if you have asked your few employees on the basis of compulsory, that CRS, that you leave the firm. Now as the need arises, you know very well that those employees are already trained, those employees know our organization well, and those employees are capable of doing meeting the need of our organization. So you can give a chance. You have the list already with you. So among the list, the best one or two which you are looking for, you can recall. You are allowing them again to join an organization on the need of organization. The next is that promotion with transfer. When your own employee, capable employee and successful employee, you in any other place, in any other branch, in any other city, if that person can give more justice to organization, you are promoting also to that person to encourage him to move from this city to other city. It is not easy for any employee to adjust in a new scenario. So just to give an incentive, you are giving promotion also, and you are also asking him to move from one city to another. So promotion along with transfer can also satisfy your internal source. Next is that waiting list. Very important. You have already undergone with a long procedure of that selection in a previous year. Now, you was in need of 10 employees, but you have made the selected list of 20 employees. It means that 10 are there in the waiting list. The whole procedure already undertaken, they have proved themselves, their capabilities are good, their medical examination and all IQ test and all testing you have done well, and you have that already selected waiting list of members with you. So again, give a call to them. Why? Because no need to go with again the whole procedure. If out of 10, if 5 are also available, with that number your need may satisfy. If that 5 have not got the proper job and they are ready to come, then your question, problem of the whole selection procedure gets over. So in this way, all these are the internal sources by which you can satisfy your need of recruitment. The second is external. Now all the time it is not possible that with the internal source your question can be solved. You have to look out. You have to think beyond. So when you are looking for the well-equipped, well-educated and with a new technological know-how, the employees you are looking for, then all these source internal may not work. So you have to go with the external sources. So external sources means beyond the organization, when you are allowing others to enter into the business organization. In this, the very first is through the advertisement. You must have observed in a newspaper, the one entire page is available where all the probable companies, those who are looking for employee, they give their advertisement. Clear? In that Times of India on the Wednesday, the SLT used to come, the special page for the employment and recruitment. So here, you are giving your information, your requirement, your expectation, and you are open up to allow everyone to come forward and to be there in the process of selection. So advertisement is the first source commonly used by all the companies, all the business organizations, those who want a qualitative good people and giving an opportunity to the available good mass employee. Number two, that through the employment exchange. The employment exchange are run by the government. Even the employment agencies at a private sector also working. So here the employment exchange keep on enrolling the available name labor force available into the various fields, in the field of commerce, in the field of science, in the field of other. So employment exchange, you approach them and you ask a list from them that these are my requirements, how many names you have ready and how many names you can recommend. So with an employment exchange, we get a good number of employees list. Next is, that is through the educational institution. Directly go to the source. When you go for the campus interview, when you entered into the campus, you have ample of probable labor available, enthusiastic, knowledgeable, and the expected employees, those who have capacity to do something new. So when you are looking for a youth, when you are looking for a very potential and capable employees, then the education institution is the very good source of recruitment. Next is, that is through the trade union. The trade union associations are there. They also maintain the list. When you are looking for the labor, you can approach them. That particularly the lower cadre employees, when you are looking for, that is the bottom level, functional level employees, more of the working employees when you are looking for, then trade union becomes a very good source of recruitment. Next is, that is the through the contractors and jobbers. Again, when you are looking for a very, as we say, that for the our trade union, like that, you want an unskilled labor, you want a temporary labor, you want a labor just for the temporary job oriented labor, then you can contact the contractors, those who are taking work from the labor. They can give you and provide you a good number of employees. Means on a contract basis, 50 people, on a contract basis, 100 people, like that. No much of the whole thing process to be done. Your work will get done and easily you can complete. Next is, that is the recruitment at the gate. When you put up an advertisement or a requirement on the gate itself, so while coming and going by, the people read, and if they feel like, they can enter into a campus and they can give their application. So again, for the lower cadre requirement of the labor, all these sources are comfortably you can use. So on the gate you are putting your requirement, people read, and especially in the GIDC area, the recruitment done like this only, they don't spend much money for advertisement or for the whole procedure. They satisfy their need by writing on the gate and get the labor. Next is, that is the modern method of recruitment, that is with the help of internet, with the help of website. Directly also you put your requisition on the website and people approach you. Or as I said, that private agencies are also running that employment exchange, and they are maintaining their list with the help of their private website. And that you must have heard the Naukri.com, or you must have heard that job wala. Like this, they have their own private agencies. They are maintaining the record and they make possible that what sort of a person you are looking for, they supply the list to you. They get the money from both the sides, at time of registration from all the probable employees, and at time of when the selection is done, they also take money from the employer. So like this, they manage their income and they make possible that two people come in contact with one another for proper placement. So in this manner, the recruitment question for 5 marks, you may have 1 mark the meaning of recruitment to be written, and 4 marks the sources of recruitment to be written. So it may be in a E section 5 mark question, or it may be in a B section 1 mark question only, what you mean by recruitment. Thank you.